Hello everyone. Most of you have probably seen the movie Justice League, and whether you liked it or not, it's undeniable that the movie could have been much better. During the production process, director Zack Snyder had to withdraw from the project, so another director, Josh Whedon of the movie Avengers, was brought in at a rather late time to finish the movie. He made changes to the movie by adding and reducing some scenes to make it less dark. Honestly, it's difficult to expect a cohesive product when there are so many changes happening. In addition to changing the director, the producer also cut down the movie to only two short scenes, which resulted in many scenes, including those shown in the trailer, being completely omitted from the original version. Currently, there is a lot of information about these missing scenes, and through my research, I have found that Dixie has the most accurate information, but only a few details have been revealed. As a fan of the movie, I wanted to gather all the available information and create a video to share with you all.
I'm going to share with you some of the most reliable information about the Justice League movie, so that you can have an accurate and comprehensive understanding of it. When I say reliable, I mean sources such as the movie trailer, casting information, interviews with the actors, and some behind-the-scenes footage that was posted on the internet by a member of the film crew. Unfortunately, I cannot share this footage due to copyright laws, but I will do my best to describe it in detail. Additionally, I will not cover every single cutscene, as some may not be significant in the overall plot.
Let's begin with the character who has been absent from the film for the longest time, Cyborg. As we can see in the trailer, there are glimpses of Victor Stone's life before becoming Cyborg, such as the scene where he walks away and the one where he plays soccer. Then, after he becomes Cyborg, we see him donning a super cool face-covering combat suit and stopping a tank to save a police officer in a battle against Superman. Additionally, there is an important character in Victor Stone's life that was cut from the film, his mother. In an interview with GameSpot, actor Ray Fisher, who plays Cyborg, revealed that there was a scene in which Victor talks to his mother, and it is a very special one. The loss of his mother is a crucial aspect of Victor's character development, as he not only has to adapt to his new body, but also cope with the pain of losing his mother. Fisher also mentioned that these scenes are highly likely to be included in the final version of the film, so let's look forward to it. Let's take a look at them on the DVD. Next are the scenes created by one of the film's brilliant artists. The first scene shows Victor wearing a Gotham High School uniform, similar to the X-Men's first-class attire. He is being attacked by a barrage of missiles, but he breaks his arm and manages to escape to one side. This scene may be interpreted as Victor's dream. The second scene depicts Victor hiding on the wall of his house, trying to avoid a parademon of Steppenwolf that is lurking nearby. The third scene shows Victor on the roof of his house, flying and struggling to maintain his balance in a similar manner to Tony Stark in Iron Man. He is still getting used to his new powers and is tense as he flies up high and above the clouds. This particular scene is visually stunning, and it is unclear why it was cut. Additionally, there are two scenes showcasing Cyborg's information technology power, one of which depicts him flying in the sky. In a crucial scene, Cyborg, Aquaman, and Flash stand before the Mother Box as Cyborg reveals a vision from the past. The scene depicts a race of German Nazis, hinting at the box's history. It appears that Cyborg is informing the Justice League about the box's past, and it is revealed that the Nazis were the ones who unearthed it from its hiding place. It is speculated that they had intentions of using it in World War II, but this is yet to be confirmed in the final version. Next up is a character who is no less impressive than Cyborg, Aquaman, also known as Arthur Curry. Once again, GameSpot has provided us with some valuable information. Based on an interview with Jason Momoa conducted by this newspaper, it has been revealed that Aquaman's underwater scenes have been significantly cut from the final version of the film. In these scenes, Arthur interacts with a crucial character named Nudis Vulko, portrayed by William Dafoe. Vulko can be seen as a bridge between Arthur and the kingdom he was born into, Atlantis. In the original Aquaman story, Vulko plays a pivotal role, particularly in the recent New 52 series. To learn more about this character, you can watch the Aquaman movie. While the exact details of these cutscenes remain unknown, Momoa has mentioned that in the film, Vulko acts as the connection between Arthur and Atlantis. He has been guiding Arthur since he was a child. It was believed that Arthur was the rightful successor of Atlantis. However, upon his arrival, he was treated as an outsider due to his father's rebellious nature. As a result, he lived a solitary life and did not contribute to the kingdom. It is unfortunate that the film did not explore this crucial aspect of Aquaman's origin, but it may be included in the DVD release.
William Dafoe's character, Nudis Volko, will also play a significant role in the upcoming Aquaman movie next year. The Flash also had many scenes cut from the trailer, including two standout moments featuring Barry Allen. One shows him fighting against a parademon, while the other has him breaking glass with his thumb. However, the best scene from this lost footage is when Barry is sitting in a restaurant, enjoying a hamburger, when he suddenly witnesses a car crash outside. Quickly, he uses his superhuman speed to shatter the glass and race to save a girl who was thrown out of the car. This girl turns out to be Iris West, who is not only Barry's girlfriend in the movie, but also the aunt of the third Flash, Wally West. This sets the stage for a memorable love story between the two characters. Unfortunately, this scene may be significantly altered as actress Kiersey Clemons, who plays Iris West, may not be returning for the upcoming film The Flash. This could mean that in the DVD version, Barry Allen saves a completely different person. Okay, that's all the evidence, and I can confirm that it's true. Now, I'd like to move on to another source. While not as reliable as the previous sources, this information comes from the person involved in the leak, and has been verified by reputable individuals on the internet. According to this person, they have seen the original version of Justice League as envisioned by Zack Snyder. I estimate its accuracy to be over 90%. Let's go over the most significant scenes from this source. The first scene was cut, in which Lois Lane and Martha talk to each other in Lois's apartment. The second scene is shorter. It features a conversation between Victor and his father. In this scene, Victor watches people on the street enjoying their lives with envious eyes. The third scene depicts a battle that took place 1,000 years ago, but some details have been altered. In the original version, the Green Lantern was more prominently featured. Additionally, the main antagonist was Darkseid, the mastermind behind Steppenwolf, and one of the most powerful villains in the DC universe. However, in the draft, Darkseid's 3D model was not yet completed, and he only appeared briefly. Next, there is a cutscene from the first battle of the Justice League against Steppenwolf. In this scene, Steppenwolf throws Wonder Woman against a wall, and then hurls a piece of debris at her, but she manages to dodge it. However, this attack causes a building to collapse, trapping the people of the Star Labs lab under a pile of rubble. The Flash uses his speed to fight off each piece of debris, but he is unable to stop the last piece from falling. Luckily, Cyborg appears just in time and shoots it, saving the people. This scene was also included in the original version. When everyone returns to Batman's base, Flash and Alfred have a longer conversation than in the movie. Flash still hugs Alfred, but it is unclear why. The scene where the Justice League enters the ship to save Superman is much longer than the one in the movie. In order for the whole team to easily get in, Cyborg's father creates a fake storm to trick everyone outside. In the next scene, Cyborg begins counting down while Flash gathers energy. As Cyborg reaches the count of one, he catches a glimpse of the future, including the downfall of the Justice League, the nightmare world depicted in Batman v Superman, and the looming threat of Darkseid.
The next cutscene shows Superman waiting for Krypton's ship to retrieve his costume. In the last cutscene, the audience witnesses Steppenwolf uniting the three mother boxes as the sky turns red and rises, prompting a strong reaction. The trailer includes scenes and dialogue that were not featured in the comic, such as when Bruce Wayne examines a three-dimensional image of Superman's costume and then meets with Alfred to retrieve it. He said you would come. Now let's hope you're not too late for my turn. Shall we?
Did he say he'll fight with us? I heard about you.
I didn't think you were real. I am real when it is useful.
I will take that as a confirmation.
What is it? The ring? This is insane.
What is this? I'm ready to engage in battle, but I've never been in a battle before.
How?
After the death of Superman.
Violence, acts of war, and terrorism are all on the decline. I had a dream. Yeah.
Now, here is the most accurate information about the lost scenes in Justice League. It is a shame for a movie with such a grand scale to have to face so many difficulties. It is also disheartening for the audience to have to pay for an incomplete product. Although I thoroughly enjoyed Justice League, I am certain that the complete version of the movie on DVD will be much better than the current version.
so let's watch it together. As mentioned in the beginning of this video, I am Jiang, the creator of this video, not Samurai Z. However, Samurai Z is an expert in the comic book industry, in the film world. I want to clarify that Samurai Z will continue to produce videos about comics, while I will be increasing the number of videos in this channel. In the near future, there will be several videos about Justice League characters, such as Green Lantern and Darkseid, as well as Marvel movies like The Punisher, The Runaways, and Black Panther. Additionally, there will be a variety of videos discussing both old and new movies. If you are interested in these topics, please click the subscribe button. Your support is our biggest motivation. Thank you, and see you again.